Hello guys, in this video we are going to see velocity contour plotting using ANSYS Fluent through a pipe, and then it is going to fall into a tank. So that is what we are going to simulate today, and this is the geometry I have made in SolidWorks. This is going to be a 2D simulation. So this just has a thickness of about 20 mm. So these are the dimension, and you can model this in SolidWorks. And while saving, you can save it as .iges file. So you can go in here and save it as .iges file. And now I have saved it as pipe into tank already. Once you are in ANSYS workbench, you can just drag and drop ANSYS Fluent. And on this, you can change this option to 2D. Right click on the geometry, import geometry, and you can browse and import the .iges file. Okay, now right click on the geometry and open it in design modeler, edit geometry in design modeler, and wait for the design modeler to open. Okay, once it is open, you can click on the import and click generate. Go into concepts, sketch from faces, and click on the back face. Do not press on the front, and click on apply, and change from frozen to add material. It makes no much difference, but I prefer to do it. And inside this, you can suppress this body, and for the surface body you can change the solid to fluid, and again it makes no difference, but I prefer to click on generate once more. There is absolutely no need to do it anyways. Then you can close this, make sure it is in 2D, and right click on the mesh and give edit. Once you are in the meshing module, click on this mesh, and if you have multiple cores in your CPU, you can take advantage of this and enter the number of threads you have, or else you can just skip this part, and you can start from here. So let this be in default and click on generate. You will majorly get a standard quadrilateral mesh since the geometry is very simple. Now this is around 7 point something × 10⁻². So I will just give 0.05, which is pretty close to what was given already. Now I'll go further down and click on generate. Still the mesh is quite large, so I will go further down and click on 0.005. okay, now the mesh is pretty good, the elements are quite small. Now you can click on this, select this, right click, and create a named selection called inlet, and we are going to choose this and name it as outlet. So you can check over here, this is the inlet and this is the outlet. Now we have the mesh, so right click on the mesh, click on update. So you can see the mesh translation to Fluent was successful. Wait until that, and then you can close. Okay, now we have done the geometry and prepared the mesh. Now we can start the setup. So if you have multiple cores, give the number of threads you have. But if you don't have, you can give it to one. Or mostly you might have two. Even in the worst case, you will have two. So it is better to take two. And make sure to select on the double precision. You can start. Once this page is loaded, you can get into here. We are going to do a transient simulation, so click transient and make sure to give gravity. So the gravity will be downwards, so it will be −9.81 m/s² obviously. And the model we are going to take K epsilon standard model, since it will be pretty easy to easy on the computer. It doesn't need much computational power. So we are going to take that. Directly we can go into the boundary conditions, and in the boundary condition we are going to give 0.1 m/s. So this will be turbulent flow, that's why we chose K epsilon model. And in the method, I am going to choose piezo, No, we can do the initialization. Click on hybrid initialization and click initialize. You can see the hybrid initialization is done. Once it is done, you can go into calculation activities, click on auto save, double click, and I am going to click on the flow time and give it as 0.1 seconds, every 0.1 seconds, and click on OK. So after you initialize, you will get this graphics tab. Right click on the counter, give new, change it to velocity, need not select any of these, just give compute and press on save or display. So you should be getting this. So this is the initial condition it is selecting. You can close this. Now go into calculation activities, right click on solution animation, click on the counter and press use active and click OK. So that is pretty much what we want to do for setting up, and for the calculation, double click on that. Make sure to make this as 80, and the number of steps will be 2000, and the time step size will be 0.001. So let's take 0.01, it should be okay. Now, after it is done, you can click on calculate. So once you click calculate, it will start the calculation. You will start getting the residuals. So for the setup what we have done, and if you chose the exact dimension what I chose for the geometry, your solution should converge without any problem. If you see the scale residuals, it is easily converging at 10⁻¹. So that is pretty good convergence rate. So it should be fine when you do this. So after the calculation is over, you can see the video. And I have already done the simulation, so I'll just pause the video.